Any questions from anyone, please? So in the last session, we discussed about the purchase invoice creation. This is a very basic information which we provide for invoice creation. So these are the points we discussed: supplier header and site, and invoice amount need to be distributed into with the different accounts. And for that, you can go with the manual distribution, or else you can use distribution set. If you use the distribution set, we have a two type of distribution sets: full distribution and skeleton distribution. In full, account and percentage. In case of skeleton, only account without any percentage. And when you have a supplier site, the site will have a specific purpose. These are the site purposes we have. And when you create the invoice, the invoice information consists of header, line and distribution information. And as a part of process, we have to create invoice. After that, we'll validate system, will verify the information within the invoice. All the header lines and distribution amount is going to be same or not. And again, it will consider some other points also. When we do the matching process, at that time we can understand those points. As a part of process, we'll create invoice, we'll validate, then we'll perform the accounting, where system will take debit and credit accounting. From where it will take, which account it will take, that we'll see in the system itself. And if required, you can approve it, or else you can ignore the approvals. It's not mandatory. And finally, we'll make the payment. To make the payment, we require bank account details. And once we make the payment, the record would be available in the tables, as well as the same record will be interfaced to cash management also for bank statement reconciliation purpose. And these are the different type of invoices we have in accounts payables: standard invoice, debit memo, credit memo, mixed invoice, prepayment, expense report invoice, recurring, withholding tax, interest invoice, retainage release, transportation invoice, and payment requests. When you talk about payment types, we have a manual payments, quick, APR netting, refund. These are the standard payment types. Apart from this, you can just make a note of another payment type also: zero payments. This doesn't fall under exactly payment type. This is a scenario based payment which will be processing the system. So these points we discuss. Now we'll see what is the purpose of these invoice types and payment types. What is the business case demands to record this specific type of invoice or this type of payment? Okay, so we'll look at these invoice types and we'll discuss one by one. If you have any questions, you can stop me and you can raise your point. Fine. The first invoice type is standard invoice. Okay, standard invoice. This is very simple. Whenever you purchase anything from the supplier, or when you take the services from the supplier, whatever the invoice you receive from the supplier, that invoice we call as standard invoice. Simply you can say supplier invoice. Okay, supplier invoice against the goods or services. Okay, standard invoice means what are the invoice we receive from the supplier. When you purchase the goods or when you render the services from supplier, so that against that purchases or services what we are taking, supplier will be sending the invoice to us when we are acting as a customer, when we are purchasing. So that invoice we call as a standard invoice. Standard invoice always will record against the purchases which we do or services which we take from the supplier. Okay, it's a very simple point. When we record the invoice, what it says how much we have to pay, when we have to pay, to whom we have to pay, where we have to send the payment. All the information you can see as a part of supplier invoice. The same points we discussed here as a part of supplier invoice information, what details we can record. Okay, you can call it as purchase invoice or you can call it supplier invoice. Why we are calling it a supplier invoice? We'll get this invoice from the supplier and we'll be recording in the system. When we get this invoice, when you purchase any goods or material or anything from the supplier, or when you take the services, okay, against the purchases, we record the invoice in the system, that we call as a standard invoice. Let's take one simple example. Say we purchased some material from the supplier for say 25,000. So when you purchase material for 25,000, we'll create the standard invoice. So standard invoice you created for say 25,000. And here we'll take the simple example. So we purchased 25 quantity, okay, 25 quantity unit price. We'll say what we purchase. Say we purchase books. So we purchase 25 books. Each book price is 1,000 rupees. So we purchased 25 books and each book cost is 1,000. So we just create an invoice with 25,000. Now say for example, you just notice the books, okay, a few pages are got damaged. After receiving the books, you identified within the few books, say 5 books, within the 5 books, you noticed few pages got damaged. In that case, what we do? We return those books back to the supplier. So when we are going to return 5 books, in our system, we have to update the invoice amount. When you create the standard invoice, the meaning is we have to pay 25,000 rupees to supplier. We have to pay 25 rupees to supplier. When we are returning that 5 quantity of books back to the supplier, the same we have to update in the system saying that 5 books returned back to the supplier, and accordingly we have to reduce the stand invoice amount and we have to maintain the remaining liability. What we have to pay to the supplier, we call as a liability. That information we have to maintain in the system. So if you take this example, we have a stand invoice for 25,000 because we purchase 25 quantity of books. Each book price is 1,000 rupees. So now we are going to return 5 books. So how much you have to reduce? 5,000. Each book cost is 1,000 rupees. So 5 books, you have to reduce 5,000 rupees. When you reduce 5,000, the finally, how much we have to pay? Only 20,000. Okay, only 20,000 we have to pay. If you have this kind of scenario in your business, okay, so whatever you have to pay to the supplier against the purchases, for that we create the stand invoice. By looking at stand invoice, we can understand how much we have to pay to the supplier. Whatever you see in the stand invoice, that we have to pay. When we have to pay and all that information also we can have within the invoice. So when you do the purchase returns, you have to reduce the amount. Based on the purchase returns, you have to reduce the amount from the stand invoice and you can update in the system still how much you have to pay to the supplier. So to reduce the amount from the standard invoice, when you perform the purchase returns, we use debit memo. Okay. When you perform the purchase returns, okay, we use the debit memo to reduce supplier liability, you can say. Okay, when you do the supplier purchase returns, to reduce supplier liability, we use debit memo. By using the debit memo, you can reduce the supplier liability. What do you mean by supplier liability? Whatever you have in the stand invoice against a specific supplier, that we call as supplier liability. Or simply you can say, by using the debit memo, you can reduce the invoice amount. Standard invoice amount you can reduce. For that purpose, we use debit memo. By using the debit memo, we can reduce the invoice amount. What is a business scenario? Purchase returns. Okay, so this is the example where we use the debit memo. Who has to create the debit memo? Being a customer, we have to rise. Whenever we identify that some defects or damage for the goods which you are purchasing, we will identify and we will inform to the supplier saying that this so-and-so items got damaged and we are going to return. So we are taking the initiative. That means debit memo always will be raised by customer who are purchasing. If they want to return something, they'll be taking the initiative. So for that, we'll say debit memo will be raised by customer. Okay. So this is a simple example to understand when we create the debit memo. And we'll take another scenario. Okay, we purchased we purchased something from the supplier. Say the amount, the case I'm taking as a, we purchased for 25,000. And later we noticed the invoice supplier has to send for 2,500. Okay, or else say we received invoice for 5,000, or say.